are you working?
No, sir, not right now. But I have worked for 3 years.
Where did you
work? In computer sciences corporation and functioning technologies.
I see. Yeah. So what is the computer literacy in India?
Sir, I do not have exact figures, but it should be around somewhere around 30%. Not more than that.
Overall?
No.
It's less.
Okay.
Okay. What is the internet penetration today in India? How many people have internet? Out of 1.3 billion people, how many people have internet?
52 crores. Huh? 52 crores.
52 crores. I don't think we have reached that figure yet.
Okay.
We are less than that. We are about 45. All right. What is the Digital India program?
Sir, Digital India is a flagship program containing several components like BharatNet project, data literacy. And sir, broadly speaking, there are three components. First, to provide data literacy. Second, to provide data infrastructure. Third, to provide government services through data world.
So, what is the BharatNet program?
The BharatNet program is the program providing high-speed broadband connectivity to gram panchayats. Around 6 lakh villages are targeted.
It will go to all the villages?
Sir, gram panchayats.
Only gram. How many grams?
I have data about villages, 6 lakh villages in the world.
What is BharatNet doing?
Sir, we have covered phase 1 and phase 2 has been started and it will provide.
What is in BharatNet? What will BharatNet do? Tell me.
Sir, optical fiber connectivity would be there, then people would be able to access the internet and government services using internet. They would be.
So, once you lay the optical fiber, they will be able to access immediately. Nothing more is required.
Sir, data literacy is required. For that, we have PM Disha program to provide data literacy to rural areas. On top of that, we have common services centers so that people who are illiterate and do not know how to access the internet, they can use the services of CSCs.
You are from which state?
Sir, Delhi.
Delhi?
Yes.
Okay. Now, aap pushing?
Can you tell us what is the money bill?
Sir, money bill, as per Article 110 of the Constitution, deals with money matters. And in money bill, the passage of money bill, Rajya Sabha's majority is not mandatory. They can only provide suggestions, and it is up to the Lok Sabha to consider those suggestions or not.
Aadhaar was passed as a money bill. What are your views on this?
Sir, Aadhaar passage as a money bill was a controversial topic and it is still being judged by the Supreme Court. It is still under sub judice matter. But sir, the provision of Aadhaar had some other matters on top of money matters as well.
You are right. Pending in the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
Now, can you tell us what is this Office of Profit?
Sir, Office of Profit basically means you are having an office and which is providing you profit out of your job. I mean, if you are a legislator but you are again assigned as chairman of some board and it is giving you some sort of profit, not necessarily monetary profit, but even if it's a position, then it will come under Office of Profit and there would be conflicts.
And why should a person, a legislator holding Office of Profit be disqualified?
Sir, it would lead to conflict of interest. In some cases, let's say I'm a MLA of my area and again I'm heading a company. Now I can formulate some policies which will help my company or myself.
Overlap between legislature and executive.
Yes, sir. Precisely.
Yeah. Can you tell us about some amendments which were made post Nirbhaya? Some amendments were made after the Nirbhaya incident in Delhi. Criminal law.
Yes, sir. Sir, one was regarding the juvenile. In India's crimes, the juvenile age was considered for 16, instead of 18. Sir, other provisions I'm not able to recall right now.
Okay. Now, can you tell me who, which constitutional authority or which, who takes oath to preserve, protect and defend the constitution?
Sir, Supreme Court.
They abide by the constitution, we are allegiance to them.
Thank you. Okay.
It's the president.
Okay. Himanshu.
Yes, sir.
Political science and international relations is your optional. Why did you choose this? Because you had computer science and engineering, your BTEC. But why did you choose this? Any specific reason?
Sir, two broad reasons. First of all, I was interested in international affairs.
Okay.
And second thing, sir, computer science, my own subject, was not in the list of subjects.
Okay, I got it. Now tell me, if I say India's constitution, it's a federal constitution but with lot of unitary features.
Yes, sir.
Do you agree or disagree?
Sir, I would agree to some extent.
If you agree, you have to justify putting some of the articles or provisions of the constitution.
Sir, we have All India Services under Article 312.
Okay. What then is All India Services?
We have Office of Governor under Article 153.
Mm.
Sir, we have. We used to have planning commission until now, but now
planning commission, does it find a mention in the constitution?
No, sir, no.
So then why are you saying? Okay.
Sir, we have finance commission under 280.
How does it say that unitary?
Okay, sir, I would again say we have in under schedule 7, the majority of the items are under union list.
Okay, but there are some state lists also.
Yes, sir.
But there's some very important provisions you are missing. You are a political science student.
Sir, emergency provisions.
But emergency provisions.
And failure when the failure.
That I get. Emergency provisions means you know the articles, okay. But I don't have to ask again.
And sir, moreover, in part 1, we have the provisions to create new state, rename a state.
Mm, that is article?
Article 3.
Article 3, you are correct. Integrated judiciary.
Yes, sir.
All these things you have to say. Hmm? Why do you take so much time to answer this question? Prepare. Okay. Then, you see, international relations, you follow international affairs also. The growing hegemony of China.
Yes, sir.
It is a cause of concern for India.
Why?
Why India should be concerned? America was also a very powerful state.
Yes, sir.
Now, the growing hegemony of China.
Sir, since the time of Xi Jinping, present premier, they have this ideology of Chinese dream of ruling the whole world, of having the biggest, of becoming the biggest superpower ever in the history. Now, for that, India is a regional power, and China is growing its influence using several projects like One Belt, One Road, Maritime Silk Route. They are actually influencing, they are extending their influence in the Indian Ocean region as well. And again, if some major power is coming into Indian Ocean region and that to China, India should be concerned.
Is it also a fact that, you know, China is behaving like a disruptive power?
Yes, sir.
In our region, because, you know, in all India's case, like UNSC. What happened in UNSC?
Sir, we wanted to designate the Jaish-e-Mohammed chief as an international terrorist, but China denied us because using their veto power.
So they are also behaving like a disruptive power also.
Yes, sir.
And growing hegemony in Indian Ocean and all this region. Okay. Now tell me another thing. You know, the power to amend the constitution is given to whom? In our constitution.
To parliament.
To parliament. Is it an absolute power?
No, sir.
Then what is the restriction?
Sir, restriction comes through basic structure doctrine. 1973 Keshavan and Bharti case and Mindira.
Okay. I got it. Okay.
You enjoy swimming and you also give first aid to stray animals.
Yes, sir.
Now the stray animals, it becomes quite a nuisance when we have cats and dogs roaming all over the place.
Yes, sir.
So how do we deal with that problem? You know, there are many cases, incidents of dogs mauling little children.
Yes, sir.
attacking little children. How do we get over the problem?
Well, first of all, there need to be awareness in the society regarding this menace. Like, even if there is a rabid dog, someone
even if there is no rabid dog,
even if it is a dog, someone need to recognize reduce the danger. Second thing comes the responsibility of the state through ABC, animal birth control rules, where we do spaying and neutering of the animals to control the population. And ma'am, if the state capacity is limited, then NGOs are involved in this process and the amount is reimbursed to the NGOs.
But just by neutering a dog, it's going to only limit the population?
Yes, ma'am.
But the ones who are already there and attack, what do you do with them?
Ma'am, if a dog only attacks when he is ill or rabid, for that we have vaccination and treatment procedure.
Now you also are interested in swimming. How is it that we haven't performed well at all on the international level? We have no swimmers worth the name.
Ma'am, I would give you several reasons. First of all, lack of infrastructure. Okay. Even in the state of Delhi, swimming is a costly exercise.
Yes.
And second thing, ma'am, there was not any motivational figure until now. Like we got majority in Australia in cricket when we won the World Cup in 83. Such sort of intervention have to be there. These are the things.
How is it that it's only cricket which gets so much of coverage? The other sports don't.
And first of the factor was motivation. Second was the factor of administration of cricket. BCCI administered it very, very well and even provided profitable revenues for youngsters.
Okay. Now, since you've lived in Delhi, you must have read and heard and seen pollution.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what are the reasons why Delhi is such a polluted city?
Ma'am, again, there are several reasons. First of all, Delhi is densely populated. It is having density of population 11,000 per square kilometer. Second thing, the number of vehicles in Delhi. Even if we combine the number of vehicles in Mumbai, Bangalore or Kolkata.
Okay, number of vehicles then?
Then ma'am, construction activities in Delhi are more.
Okay.
Due to the road dust and all things. And ma'am, environmental factors. It is not closer to the sea.
What about the Badarpur power plant? What about
yes,
the brick kilns? All those are leading to pollution.
Yes,
so we have lots of directions being given by NGT and other bodies. Can you give some of their recommendations?
Yes, ma'am. As per graded action plan given by NGT and the Central Pollution Control Board, whenever PM 2.5 and PM 10 concentrations go, there are several phases where you
but
can.
But even otherwise, even if we don't have this on a daily basis, what can be done and what is being recommended?
And usage of private vehicles should be limited, should be restricted in a sense. Public vehicles should be promoted. And audible comes into action when emergency is there. And closure of these brick kilns and power plants. And sewage management is an important factor in this. Segregation at source. And moreover, ma'am, we have landfills in Delhi which are causing a lot of pollution. So we need to find another way to manage this solid waste.
Now you've done computers, etc. So tell me something about artificial intelligence. Why is it becoming so important? Everyone is discussing artificial intelligence.
Well, until now we had only humans as intelligent beings. Now when you impart that intelligence into machines, it becomes artificial intelligence. Let's suppose the task we were doing before, manning the borders, performing operations, manual labor tasks, these all can be done by robots and artificial intelligent machines.
Okay, my last question about regional air connectivity. There's this scheme. Can you tell me something about this scheme?
Yes, ma'am. It comes under Udhe Deshka Aam Nagari Udan scheme of the government, where we are providing new greenfield airports and reviving brownfield airports. And we are providing subsidies, and there has been a capped limit of 2500 per
1 hour.
Per 1 hour. Ma'am, it involves helicopters as well.
So they're only going to give 50% of seats in this, and what about the remaining?
50% of the seats they can earn profit.
And how are they going to make use of all the funds that they require? From where will the funds come?
Ma'am, on domestic flights, they have put a fee. I'm not sure about the fee name, but they put a fee on that.
Viability gap funding.
Viability gap funding is there.
All right, thank you.
Himanshu, what were the objectives behind demonetization?
Sir, to curb the menace of black money, for bringing the undisclosed sources of income into formalized economy. and to promote data economy.
Have these objectives been realized? Or to what extent they have been realized?
If we go by the data, 99.8% of the money came back. We thought there would be a large amount of black money, but that wasn't there. Or people were able to launder the money. But in the case of data economy, yes, we have progressed in that case, where data transactions have been increased.
Was there any other advantage?
Yes, sir. The direct tax and indirect tax, collections increased a lot, and there were a significant amount of investment in the stock market.
That I don't know whether that can be attributed to demonetization, but yes, direct tax collection has gone up,
yes,
and also the tax base has widened.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. There are, you know, two kinds of economic policy. One is fiscal policy, the other one is monetary policy. What is the difference between the two?
The monetary policy relates to the amount of money circulated in the economy. That is done by RBI. And fiscal policy is the taxation policy or other policy related to.
What are the instruments of fiscal policy and what are the instruments of monetary policy? Just mention two or three.
So fiscal policy, we have tax, indirect tax, direct tax. And monetary policy, we have repo rate, reverse repo rate.
Okay, now you mentioned one or two fiscal concerns and one or two monetary concerns.
Sir, fiscal concern would be a fiscal deficit. It has actually grown in this year's budget.
Right. Okay.
Debt to GDP ratio.
Okay, good.
And the current account deficit.
These are all fiscal concerns.
Yes, sir.
Monetary concerns?
Monetary concerns is, sir, one thing would be the amount of high value currency in the total circulation.
Inflation.
Inflation, sir, definitely. Yeah. Inflation is the main
interest rate. The stock going on about holding simultaneous elections. Some people there are suggesting that we should go into simultaneous elections. What is your take?
Sir, it's a new idea. I think we should approach it, but we should approach it cautiously, keeping all the factors in mind that it has some positive as well as some negatives.
Just mention one or two positives.
The positive would be you have model code of conduct, and the policy of the country is always in the election mode. If simultaneous elections are there, there would be a clear cut mandate that you.
Okay, so this is the positive side. Negative side?
Sir, it tends to affect the cooperative federalism that we have, because voter can sometimes vote for the national leader or national party, even in the regional elections.
Also, I think it will put tremendous pressure on the
machinery.
Exit polls and opinion polls, what is the difference?
Sir, exit polls is the one when the person is voting and he is being asked whom you voted after he has voted. Opinion polls is about opinion before the elections.
What is the legal position in India?
Sir, opinion polls are banned. Exit polls are allowed. Opinion polls are allowed. Exit polls are banned, but they need to be released only after the day of voting has been over in all the state elections.
Now there are two types of system. One is presidential system, the other one is parliamentary system.
Yes, sir.
We have opted for the parliamentary system.
Yes, sir.
Some people suggest that we should presidential system of governance is a better alternative. You agree on that? What are the advantages of a presidential system?
In a diverse country like India, we need a parliamentary system, because the representatives coming from different backgrounds being elected, this won't be in the presidential system. It would have a central leader, a powerful leader, who can appoint his own cabinet and his own representatives. But in the parliamentary system, even smaller states give their contribution and elect their representative.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
The scope of Article 21 has expanded vastly. What is the latest addition to it?
Sir, we can say right to privacy is the latest addition. Along with that, right to eat your, decide your own food, and right to choose your private life that involves your preferences in different spheres.
You know the case of Hadia from Kerala?
Yes, sir.
What principle did Supreme Court establish? What was the ground on which Supreme Court rejected the demand of the father and all. Of course, the case is still pending, but Supreme Court has made its mind very clear.
The blood is not a minor, and he has the right to choose his own life and to choose his own partner.
So two consenting adults,
yes, sir.
Nobody can interfere. Again, yes, it's a right to privacy.
Yes,
what was a principle affirmed by Supreme Court in Padmavat case?
The right to creative freedom. I'm not too sure, sir, about this.
Freedom of speech and expression?
Yes, sir.
Simple?
Article 9.
What principle it affirmed in the triple talaq case?
Sir, I'm not too sure, but it was about right to equality and...
Simple. Women have a constitutional right.
Yes, sir.
Right to equality. Article 15. Now, Menka Gandhi case, what principle, legal principle was established by Supreme Court in this case?
The principle of judicial review? No. Sorry, sir.
Due process of law?
Due process of law, yes, sir.
Can you define due process of law?
Sir, in due process of law, Parliament, Supreme Court is able to even adjudicate, even to review the cases, the law decided by the legislature. It is different from procedure established by the law that is being followed in US.
No, it means? It's
been followed in UK. No.
That's okay. But the real principle is that a law must be just, fair and reasonable.
Okay.
And procedure must follow the principles of natural justice.
Okay.
These are the two principles with due process. Now, can you identify some fundamental rights which are women specific, which give constitutional rights to women?
Sir, in Article 21, you have a particular right where women cannot be put behind those chains.
Why? Not Article 15, 16?
Yes, sir. Specific mention for women is there.
Right. On what ground women have been allowed to go into temples where so far entry was barred? Article 15?
Yes, sir.
Think of those. What is Westphalian model? Westphalia? Yeah. Westphalia?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard it in international affairs?
Yes, sir.
Westphalian model? What is this Australian model of states?
Sir, I am not able to recall exactly.
You were asked about hegemony of China.
Okay.
What is a hegemonic model?
The hegemonic model is one in which country expand its spheres of influence in other countries in affairs as well.
So, Westphalian is the opposite of it.
Okay.
Nation states respecting their boundaries. What are global commons?
Sir, established set of principles in which all of us agree for greater good.
No, global commons are those entities in the world or in the universe which are everyone's property. No one can own them.
Okay, just like we have oceans.
Now yours, right. High seas. What else?
I'm not getting it, sir.
No. But international relation, you should be able to say this. All right. Why is Cape Town coming to notice for some serious problems?
Sir, Cape Town is facing severe water shortage. It's been facing due to climate change.
Correct.
Correct.
You got it. Okay. All right, we close the interview.